Hey, how's it going? Trail Freak here, coming at you from Trail Freak Garage. So, working on my 61 Mercury, trying to get it back on the road. It's been sitting here for about a year. Overheating problems, so been doing some work slowly. That's why I haven't made videos on it, because I work on it for like 5 minutes and I do something else. Dang ADHD, I believe. I don't know what it is, but anyway, I'm not far from getting it back together. I gotta get the rockers back in, get all the front stuff, water pump, all that stuff back on, get the wheels back on, do some wiring. I have the blinkers are not working for whatever reason, so got wiring issues. Interior is not looking too great right now, so I'm just going to be using the old Mexican blankets there to cover some of the bad spots up on that, and should be ready to go. And what I'm getting it ready for is hopefully cruising the coast. So I'll be going down there at the middle of the week of cruising. The cruising is the first weekend or first week in October, and I've only been once just to check out the rides, but this will be my first time taking a ride. That is, if I can get it going. And that's what I'm trying to do. Like, so I'm no expert on this kind of stuff. I mean, I've tinkered with cars, you know, ever since I was a teenager, but nothing major, you know, just some little stuff, you know, basic stuff. I don't know much, a whole lot about what I'm working on, just a little bit. I've tinkered with cars ever since I was a teenager, but nothing crazy, like fabrication and stuff like that. But I have worked on a few things. Had a 89 Mustang that I hot rodded a little bit, and that's about it. And take 25. So I'm not a pro at this kind of stuff. Amateur. I'm barely amateur, but I know just enough to get by, I believe. So okay, I don't know what I'm talking about. I'm just going to start working on this thing. My brain is teetered out, I believe. Alright, so I'm going to try to do some work on here, so stay tuned. And let's hope I get this thing running before October. I got less than 3 weeks. All right, these Y-block intakes are pretty dang heavy. This whole motor is freaking heavy. A lot of good old iron. So I don't have too much more to go on this thing, I don't believe. Get the thing bolted up. Get my water pump and all that stuff on. And I need to get a new distributor cap and all that stuff, and new fuel filter. And hopefully, get this thing fired up by the end of this weekend. This weekend's coming up. This day is Thursday here right now. So hopefully Sunday I have it fired up. If not, I just keep plugging at it until I get it. Like old Rat Rod Bob says, I'm getting it, just ain't got it. Something like that anyway. Woohoo. Okay, can't remember if I took the radiator out, then took the fan, or did I take the fan out, then the radiator? Okay, let's... I believe I'm going to put the fan on first. I'm going to take the radiator back out and put the fan on. So much for doing that once. tight fit there. I just had these bolts. So I don't have to take that back off. On that, but it's been so long since I worked on this thing, and since I've had it apart, I forgot. Well, that's what fell out. Thank you. be a pain. Transmission lines hooked back up. Let's get our belts back on. Yep, built on, and I'm gonna take my crap out. I'm so freaking disorganized, I can't find anything when I need it. Looking for my pry bar, can't find my pry bar. Okay, well, I could spend an hour looking for it, so I'm gonna get something else. Now that I don't need a pry bar anymore, that son of a gun will probably show up. Got my, let's see, all right, let me tighten this up. That's on. Get my lower radiator moving on. So yeah, as soon as I got through doing that, I found my pry bar. That's the way it goes, every time, every time. Starting to look like something. It's starting to look like something put together. About time. I'm almost there. I'm seeing the finish line, I believe. I got everything. I think the only thing I got left, I got to hook the carburetor up, get the linkage and all that stuff done. Then I got to make sure my timing is all right. I got to take all my spark plugs out, or take the first one out and get the top dead center and make sure my distributor is pretty close to time. And I believe late tonight I have this thing fired up, hopefully. Got changed oil, all that too. But hopefully tonight is the night that this thing fires up for the first time in over a year. So. Well, I'm beyond pissed right now. I don't see how I didn't see it when I put the heads on. But this little white wire, freaking oil pressure wire, has screwed me royally. It's pinched in between the head and the block. How? Did I not see that? What the freak? Jeez. 2 days left to go to cruising the coast, and I gotta break the freaking. Woosa. Woosa. So, I'm gonna get to work and get that dang wire out of there. I'm so dang PO'd, man. Shit. In the process of breaking this thing back down to get that stupid ass wire. Alright, I got the wire out. Look how flat that is. Got a lot of pressure on it. Yep. That little bastard right there. I got it finally. I didn't have to take everything complete. I didn't have to take the head completely off or the intake. Thank goodness. I'm just hoping now that everything will seal back up. Let's hope. Oh.
Okay. Got that stupid wire out. I'm thankful I didn't have to break the whole top end down. I just was able to loosen some stuff up, and lift the head up a little bit and pull that dang wire out. Man, I was in my feels about that. Man, that was tough. But I got it all together. I'm getting ready to hook the battery up and get this thing cranked up. We'll see if it will crank. Well, she fired off. That's good. Now I gotta tinker around with it to get it to stay running. So she's starting up pretty good. So that gas is old, so I'm gonna get some fresh gas, change oil, and get coolant in her. And try to get the idle some. I don't know much about carburetors. I don't know much about anything really. But might have to do a little bit. I bet you if I got fresh gas in there, it'd probably stay cranked up. So get the fresh gas, then try it, and I'll be back. All right, I finally got her cleaned up. Oil change, coolant in, everything's going good. She's running pretty decent. So she's ready for cruising the coast. And man, that was a tough couple of weeks, or a couple of days. All them stretched out. Anyway, it was pretty tough. I didn't think I was gonna make it. I still may not make it. But yeah, I gotta take about 4 hours to get down there. And, hopefully we'll see me cruising. It's running pretty decent. So I haven't taken it on test drive. I just cranked it up, drove it around the yard, loaded it up on the trailer. So my test drive is gonna be at cruising the coast. And we're gonna try to go have some fun. So, see you down there on the coast.